This video is sponsored by brilliant.org. Check the link in the description for a discount on your first subscription. Hey guys, I'm Nate. Welcome back to the workshop. Today we're going to be taking a little bit of a look at ferrofluid. That's a liquid that's attracted to magnets and makes some really cool shapes when it's in a magnetic field. The basic recipe for our ferrofluid that we'll be making today is one that I got from a channel called Brainiac75. They've got a lot of cool videos about ferrofluid, so if you're interested in seeing more, go check them out. Before we start making our ferrofluid, I wanted to talk a little bit about what it is and why some recipes do and don't work. The basic idea of a ferrofluid is a liquid that's attracted to a magnetic field. This is done by suspending a ferrous chemical inside a liquid base. To work properly, a ferrofluid needs at least three main components. The first is a magnetic powder that can be suspended in the fluid. We'll be using magnetite, a synthetic black iron oxide. Once we have our magnetic powder base, we need a fluid to suspend it in. And this is where it can get a little bit tricky. An issue we quickly run into is that most liquids will not stick to the microscopically small particles that make up our magnetic powder. We may be able to get our powder wet, but as soon as a magnet is introduced, all of the particles will stick together so closely that there's no longer any space in between the individual ones for our fluid base. Let's see what happens if we try mixing our powder with plain water. This cup now has a mixture of a little bit of water and some of our magnetite powder. You can see that it hasn't mixed in very thoroughly. At the bottom, there's still sort of a thick, goopy paste with a thinner black liquid on top of it. Now, this thinner liquid does have our magnetite suspended through it pretty well at this point. So you might think, hey, that should work. Won't that be magnetic? But watch what happens when we actually put a magnet up against it. Look at that, it squeezes the magnetic powder so much that it just pulls all of it right out of the water. You can see we are now getting water that's almost clear again. We've just pulled all of the magnet powder right out of there. It does look kind of cool though. You can see all of the magnetic powder flowing through the water over to the magnet. So the water clearly doesn't work. And that brings us to the third element that we need in our ferrofluid, and that's what's called a surfactant. The word surfactant comes from a combination of the words surface active agent. A surfactant is something that lowers the surface tension between two substances. What we're looking for is one that will work as a wetting agent to make sure that our liquid base will surround every individual particle of our magnetite powder. Motor oil does exactly what we're looking for. It's a liquid oil base with surfactants added to make it stick well to the surface of oil. This particular brand is the same kind that was recommended by Brainiac75 on his channel, but I've tried it with a couple of other brands of synthetic motor oil and they seemed to work just as well. So now let's take some of our oil and some of our magnetite powder, mix them together and see what happens and how it's different from mixing it with water. Now we have our motor oil in the cup. Let's add magnetic powder to it until it becomes a fairly uniform consistency. There we go, we now have a fairly thick liquid mixed up, and that is our Castrol Magnetech oil mixed with our magnetite powder. Let's see how our liquid responds to a magnet. Oh, there we go. You can see it's definitely getting pulled onto it there. And we're also even starting to get a few fun little shapes forming. Look at that.
The walls of this cup get coated pretty quickly in our black paste, so to make it easier to see, let's pour our liquid out onto a plate and then see how it reacts to a magnet.
All right, let's move our plate over our magnet and see how this goes. You can definitely see it reacting. We're starting to get some of those cool little spiky shapes that we're looking for from a ferrofluid. That's pretty cool. All right, now let's watch what happens if I take the magnet away from the mixture. Just kind of puddles back down. We have all our fun little spikes. Take it away and they all just smooth themselves right out. Now that's pretty neat, but this ceramic magnet is actually not all that powerful. So let's see what happens if we use something a little bit stronger. We've got four neodymium magnets all stuck together right here, and this should provide some pretty intense power, hopefully not too much power.
see the result. I don't want to break my plate either. Oh boy.
Yeah, look at that. It's so close to the magnetic field, and the magnetic field is so strong that we're not getting the normal points we're looking for. We're just getting some interesting plate spots on the most concentrated bits of the magnet. Also, see this little puddle of oil in the middle? That's what I was talking about by using magnets that are too powerful. It's actually squishing our magnetic powder together so powerfully that it's squeezing the oil out from in between the particles. Let's try and take this magnet off and then back it away so it's not quite as close to our magnet powder.
We've added two more plates that should keep our magnets a little more separated from our ferrofluid. Now let's see how it reacts. We're still getting the four different concentrated points, so our four magnets are clearly not all acting as one powerful magnet, which makes sense.
There we go, look at that. Oh, that's beautiful. Those spikes are fantastic. As long as I keep moving the magnet, they sort of keep growing in the magnetic field. If I just hold the magnet still, of course, they don't move anywhere. Just to illustrate that it's only when I'm moving the magnet that the fluid is moving with it.
Well, that was a pretty powerful magnet. Now I also have some ultra powerful magnets. These things are huge and so strong. I'm afraid it might be too strong and it might just pull the magnetic powder right out of the oil, but we gotta try it.
Oh my gosh, it's still like fully an inch away. Ooh, we're getting good results though. Spikes are giant.
Holy cow, that looks so cool. Let's see what happens if I pull the magnet away. Wow, we've got these giant spikes. Bloop! Puddled back down. Magnet back. Ooh, we got sort of these like weird ridges instead of regular spikes.
Not quite what I had in mind, but also kind of neat.
There we have it, our ferrofluid. May not be quite so runny or thin as some commercially available ferrofluids, but it does respond well to magnets, and we do get those cool points sticking out of it just the way we want it to. One more test I want to try, because I know a lot of you are going to want to see it. Let's see what happens if we freeze it with liquid nitrogen. I have a prediction, and I think the liquid nitrogen is going to freeze the motor oil and it will become so rigid that it no longer responds to the magnets. Well, let's find out. Now, pouring the liquid nitrogen on just like this would be no fun, so let's try and get some good spikes on there and then freeze those so that they stay even when we remove the magnet.
All right, those are some good spikes. Put on the safety glasses. Let's see about freezing our ferrofluid. Hopefully it doesn't just shatter my plate. It's a very real possibility, I understand. Oops, a little much there. Let's see what happens if I take away the magnet. Well, I would say we've got some good frozen spikes. That's actually kind of cool. Keep adding more to keep it nice and frozen. Yeah, normally without a magnet, these things are just gone. But now I've got some frozen motor oil in spike shape. And poke them. Oh, now I got some of the unfrozen stuff on my magnet. That's annoying.
There you go, how to make your very own ferrofluid using magnetite powder and Castrol Magnetech motor oil. This stuff is pretty fun to play with, although I do recommend you wear gloves because motor oil is designed to stick to stuff, and this stuff is very black in color. So if you get any of it on your hands, it's going to be on your hands and it's going to spread to everything you touch. It's really hard to get off, even with soap and water. If you've got any ideas on how to make ferrofluid that's a thinner consistency, more like the commercially available ferrofluid, let us know down in the comments. I would love to try all of your ideas, and if one of them works, we'll make an updated video showing you how to make that kind of ferrofluid, and we'll send you 25 bucks. Well, now we know that ferrofluid is made from a magnetic powder base, a liquid base, and some kind of surfactant. Motor oil already has a liquid base and a surfactant in it. so it bonds well to our magnetite powder to give us a ferrofluid. Liquid nitrogen will freeze our ferrofluid solid, so it remains spiky even when we take our magnets away from it. If you love these kinds of hands-on experiments, you're probably the type who would like to know more about our sponsor, Brilliant.org. Brilliant.org is a math and science enrichment program which provides their members with engaging and interesting problems, which helps them understand the concepts at a more fundamental level. The program is set up so that the problems are presented in an engaging and addictive experience, and when your brain is more interested in what it's learning, it becomes easier to understand. If you have an interest in increasing your understanding of math, science, or problem solving, Brilliant.org can help you achieve those goals. To support the King of Random and learn more about Brilliant, head to brilliant.org/kingofrandom. The first 567 people will receive 20% off the annual premium subscription. Thanks for joining us for this video, and remember to come gear yourself up with products and merch at thekingofrandom.com. See you there. Your motor oil looks like this in your car. Get an oil change and talk to a mechanic.
Oh, that part's not frozen at all. Gross.